Hi, how are you? You've reached Carrie Ann, and you're watching Kai TV, your home for the healthiest, the wealthiest, and the happiest information. Woohoo! Woohoo! Thank you so much for tuning in. And today, you have tuned into an awesome segment. So we're going to discuss some life lessons. One of my favorite life lessons that I've learned over some time of being on this planet for the length of time that I have been. If you want to know how old I am, you're going to have to go to the blog and read. I wrote a beautiful article about my age and celebrating it. So, life lessons. We've all have them, but do we view them as lessons or do we overlook them as an experience that happened to us instead of an experience that happened for us to gain insight, to gain knowledge, to gain information about how we should show up in our next phase, in the next portion of our life? Most people don't. Most people, when things happen to them, they look at it as a bad experience. Oh my God, poor me. Why me? Why? So the topic that I want to talk about is having people in your life that you thought would be in your life forever, no longer be there, just disappear, leave you hanging high and dry. Why? How does that make you feel? For me, when this scenario happens, and I found that it happened generally right after I had a huge transformation, a spiritual transformation. So what I was able to see from retrospect was that the divine was moving me in a certain direction that these individuals weren't prepared or ready to come with. And I have this beautiful saying that I have acquired over the years and I live by it. Reason, it's another trilogy, like I love three things. Oh, I love it. What are these three things that we should pay attention to in our lives surrounding individuals that have left us and have us, in a sense, it could have us feeling empty, angry, or confused. So the way I look at the situation is that when people leave, exit my life without giving me a reason or in a weird or awkward way, I view them as either the universe sent them in the first place to me for a reason. So when I look at it as a reason, I'm like, what lessons was I supposed to learn from their presence in my world? What did they bring with them that enhanced my life? Or woke up things that were sitting dormant that I had kind of brushed under the proverbial carpet and not giving my attention to. What did they awake within me that needs work? Or what did they awake within me that was so beautiful that was a part or is a part of me that I had abandoned and forgotten about? So I look at that. So the lessons. Then when I find the lessons, I thank them and release them. Two, which is beautiful, is season. So I look at it and say, okay, this person showed up for a certain length of time because, again, within that time, I was made to go through something and they were there, in a sense, as my angel. Because the people that we have in our life, more often than not, are in our lives because we enjoy their company. We enjoy what they have to give us. And how our relationship dynamic is. If we don't, then that's a whole different story. We're having them in our lives because of a habitual belief that we deserve to be treated a certain way and not the ideal way from a place of love. But if we're speaking about individuals who are in our lives and they are operating and dealing with us from a place of love and we enjoy their company and then suddenly they up and go after a length of time, then their time with us has just expired. No harm, no foul. No animosity should be expressed from you. You should just look at the situation as, oh my gosh, beautiful. I was blessed enough to be able to spend time with this person and gain the beauty of having them in my life, you know, learning from them and learning the lessons and having them either, you know, if they showed up as a protector, gaining that as well and seeing the beauty in the overall picture. So we've gone through two so far. So reason, season. And then these are my favorite. Ooh, these ones are my fave. These ones are the lifers. The lifers. Ooh, I love the lifers. The lifers are the ones you know from the beginning. Sorry, just slapped my nose. So you know from the beginning that these guys, girls, guys, are in your life forever. And the connection, it's a soul deep, you know, yummy connection that you know is so authentic and so real, and there's nothing but divine love at the base, at the edges, at the, you know, the top, the bottom, all around it, surrounding it, it's love. And even if you have your disagreements or whatever the case may be, you know that this person, they're in your life forever, and it's a good in your life forever. You know, you're gaining so much from them, you're learning so much from them, and in a sense you're both enhancing each other's life, because relationships are a two-way street, right? So the lifers are my favorite, because those are the ones you can spot right away, and those are the ones that despite going through storms and tornadoes and, you know, turbulence, you know that the foundation is so solid that you're both going to still be there for each other and support each other and love each other. And, you know, when you find a life partner that embodies this characteristic, oh my goodness, you are like in heaven. You're in heaven. And I say relish that and work and, you know, cherish that bond. By no means should you make the mistake, though, that if this person shows up and it feels like such, that your relationship doesn't include work. Every relationship includes work. You have to work at it. Life is about working through your challenges and learning from these challenges, right? So those are my three little insight, goody, goody, goodness for you to learn. These are your life lessons. Take them and do with them what you will. Thank you so much for spending your time with me, sharing space, and allowing me to dialogue with you. I appreciate you and I love you, and I wish you nothing but health, wealth, and happiness. Remember, you are a beacon of light. Go out and shine it in someone's world. Make them happy, uplift them, and enhance their world today and always. That's your job. That's your duty. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and head on over to the website, the blog, and sign up for our weekly newsletter so that you're in the know, that you don't miss out on anything that I offer or that I announce or that I have available for you. Okay, thank you, thank you, thank you again, and I wish you a wonderful, blessed afternoon, evening, or night, wherever you are. Love. Bye-bye.